Our weekend continues with qualifying, as the drivers fight it out for a strong grid position.
Qualifying means everything around Monaco. With little chance of overtaking in the race, getting as far up the grid as possible and keeping the car intact is every driver's goal on this unforgiving circuit.
In terms of George Russell and his form, Karun, how's he going to be feeling, do you imagine?
Well, neither teammate has really managed to score well so far. Perhaps picking up a few points this weekend would spur on a bit of healthy rivalry.
So here we are, ready to resume.
So the circuit should be all clear. So you're good to go. So no one ahead.
Good to go.
A P6 at the moment. There it is, so box and call the car. Okay.
End of this lap.
Okay.
Okay.
circuit is all clear. Good to go. Keep an eye on that delta. So call the car and we'll box.
Understood. Clear ahead. Good to go. That's P5.
Let's just focus on the out lap. Pick up the pace.
Yep.
Rear brakes.
Copy.
Is that happy to push now?
Copy. And we can drop the lift and coast for now, we'll make it up later.
Understood.
Yeah, we just need to make sure that we don't fall off a cliff on that tyre.
Yep.
So just charge that pack.
Okay.
Just manage these tyres.
Copy.
Charge the pack.
Copy. Careful with the warm-up.
Brakes a bit.
Copy. circuit's all clear. Good to go.
And happy to pick up the pushing level.
Coming.
Push and hold, overtake.
Coming.
We have a checkered flag now.
Seven. Nice job.
Good team effort.
Tension continues to build here as race day begins.
Monaco can hand out unpredictable results, just like in 1982, when four race leaders hit trouble. Ricardo Patrese eventually claimed the win after managing to restart his stalled car by himself with a downhill bump start.
Lewis there, getting himself ready for today's race. Caroon, how's he going to be feeling at the moment, do you think?
You know, it's not going well for them at the moment. They haven't been able to put everything together, and it's going to be a lot of work to get back to where they need to be.
So as the drivers prepare to weave their way around the streets of Monaco, you have to think there'll be twists and turns aplenty. The streets of Monte Carlo are ready as the drivers prepare for the 78 laps of the Monaco Grand Prix. The anticipation and excitement may be building up, but there's a cool head on Carlos Sainz.
They're in second place on the grid, but that could so easily change in the first few seconds after lights out.
But remember, anything can happen in Formula One. We're here and the streets are abuzz at the Monaco Grand Prix. And it's lights out! And away we go!
Let's push and get past him. Just show me what you've got.
Copy.
Just keep pressure close, you can do this. Let's go for it.
Yep.
Just drop back a bit.
Copy.
Yeah, we just need to make sure that we don't fall off the cliff on that tyre. Keep these tyres in good nick.
Understood.
Right then, we can take a look now. Now this was at turn one. The opportunity's there. And Lewis says, thank you very much.
Just stay close to him.
Red flag, red flag.
Let's see what happened there. Right, let's have a look as we go into turn four. Oh, and the car with a nasty crash into the barrier. Well, following a crash like that, it'll be important now to ensure that any debris is cleared from the scene. And just like that, the hopes of the team start to dwindle. Our race here resumes as we get back underway. And it's lights out, and away we go.
Push and hold, overtake.
Yeah, I copy.
Let's have a look at that. Heading to Sandoval.
It's lights out!
It's certainly inviting.
And away we go!
That takes them to seventh place. Let's take a look at the replay. Now, this one involves Stroll. It's there for the taking. And that puts them in sixth.
No management here required. So we're low on battery at the moment.
Start reducing that management.
Coming.
a bit.
Okay.
What exactly happened there, Karun?
We see the Williams crew ready here. Oh, it's the rear left that's gone too loose, though.
Here's the replay. Now we're watching Carlos Sainz here. Can they squeeze by?
It is, so box, box.
In the boxes now.
So head down.
Understood.
Okay, let's see what you got then.
Copy.
We should be clear on exit.
Make sure keep these tyres in good nick.
Okay.
Okay, copy that. Traffic on exit. 26 laps. Temps are climbing. Temps are now climbing. Pull to one side in places, that will help. And four laps remain. Two laps remain. And think about left lifting coast. So let's uplift the coast all round. And we can drop the lifter coast for now, we'll make it up later.
Sainz crosses the line first. He's taken the win.
Push and hold, overtake.
Coming.
So we have taken the flat. P7, mate. Another challenging day.
Let's keep pushing. This is really positive for us all, guys.
So that's the checkered flag. P8. Good race.
Just keep pushing. All right, nice work.
And that's another race done for Fernando Alonso. And Carlos Sainz heading up to the podium now, the Spaniard adding another to his record.
What an excellent way to take a second win of the season with a composed performance today.
Always a special occasion here in the incomparable Monte Carlo. They'll be pushing the boat out here tonight, no doubt. As proceedings start to wind down here, what will Mercedes have made of this result, Karun?
They did okay today, I'd say. I mean, we're talking about such a competitive field, and all things considered, the drivers did all right.
And thank you, everyone, for joining us this weekend here in Monaco.
Formula One will be back to Europe for the next round, on the shores of the Mediterranean, with some heated competition to look forward to in Spain.